What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Scarfinger, and I was supposed to stay away for a little while I actually got the other videos out, but I wanted to play some more 2K, and so I decided to come back and play some more with this character. So here I am. It's college time, freshman year of college. I chose the Texas Longhorns just for something different, and we're about to get into it. So, how was your boy? Let's play some ball. Now, I wonder how this draft projection thing actually works, because it's you know, they talked me up during some of these, and my last character did terrible in college. He was not very good at all. And we didn't win a whole lot. They won despite me, not because of me, but my stock kept going up and down or stayed the same. I wonder if does that actually change, or, you know, do I actually change that? What I do actually change that, or does it go up and down, depending on the, you know, what the story calls for. So, yeah, so I guess we're about to play, about to get a college on. So work on three, one, two, three, three work.
Welcome everyone to an exciting broadcast of college basketball here on 2K Sports. Some great action in store tonight, seeing some of the best and brightest young players on the hardwood. This is Kevin Harlan, joined by my colleagues Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony.
I have a question about we'll see the Villanova and the Texas Longhorns.
And the thing you love about collegiate sports, the passion, the energy. I mean, the competitiveness and that hunger and drive to succeed and show what you have. It's really always a marvel to watch.
Is the color brown or is it a dark brown?
No doubt about it, Greg. And seeing these players out here tonight, I remember how the love for the game of basketball in those formative years when I was playing college was so invaluable. I mean, the experience you gain with excellent coaching and mentorship at this level is really a huge part of where you go with your talent.
So on the floor for Villanova, they've got Miller. Cooper is out there with Bryant. And it's Ilgauskas in at the four spot. Just five to shoot. Here's Cooper. That's in, coming off an assist from Bryant.
Villanova might
Cooper's got the first basket of the game for Villanova.
Well, it'll only be cool
well who
I'm
could
like,
forget Villanova and their one college title? Come on now. It was one of the biggest Cinderella stories ever. One of the greatest upsets ever. Winning it all as an eighth seed, knocking down an outstanding Georgetown team back in 85.
And Beal kicks to Bryant. Here's Cooper. Good work defensively by Turner.
One thing with Freak that we know is he makes sure he gets his shots up no matter what.
Oh,
one way or another, he's going to get his work.
He was wide.
And that's why so many are confident that he'll continue to improve.
Part of it is that he has a twin sister who actually taught him how to play ball. She helped him develop his game and become the player he is today. Pretty nice to have a sibling willing to help you develop your skill set on the court. I think it's safe to say that the most notable Longhorn of all time is Kevin Durant. Only spent 1 year there, but that's all the time he needed to leave his mark on the program.
And we've seen Durant go on to do great things in the NBA, but he had that one magical season with the Longhorns.
Yeah, you go back to his freshman year, he was player of the year. The first freshman to achieve that status. Absolutely dominated in every way on the floor. You knew the NBA was in his future immediately.
Obviously, he doesn't really want to shoot the
deal with it.
So,
on the pass to Cooper.
Back off of him. That dude is just blocking everything. Wow, they're taking everybody out except me. But that's what it looked like. I think the center still stayed in too. Yeah, he still stayed in. There's the block party right there.
Yeah.
this is, we're back to where we're on half. So even though it's a little bit longer. That's cool. Sound effects. And you know something? I picked some sound effects with another character, and it seems like that character, the stuff that I picked for that character, is actually on this one. But things seem to be going I'm doing a lot better than I did before, maybe because my character is a lot better than that version of Freak because of the points that I use. I mean, really, the character, I mean, my overall rating right now is like a 64, and my previous character, his rating after playing a whole season already is like a 62. Oh shit, that's my bad. I tried to miss up the kick and then I didn't get there in time. That's on me. That's on me. We're doing alright. I didn't get time. The one assist I could have gotten. Not quite real with that, but...
And we welcome you back to college basketball here on 2K Sports as we get ready to get going for the second half of play.
Guys, we had a tight game through the first half. I think we'll see more of the same.
I hear the announcers now.
And it's just going to take
I don't remember hearing the first half of this game.
If we can get that, that's a great chance of coming away with the victory.
Freak, he's in a point guard. Also, Ellis out there. Doherty out there with Turner. And it's Ford in at the power forward.
Shout out to
the Texas Longhorns. Been building their basketball program over the years. They have been on the verge of greatness for a long time.
I think Texas in general is very decorated in its athletics program. I mean, still looking for their first college basketball championship on the men's side is what they're reaching for.
So on the floor for Villanova, they've got Cooper. Miller is out there with Bryant. And it's Ilgauskas in the four slot.
The block party.
And while the Longhorns don't have any college titles in men's basketball, they have yet to even make it to the final game of the tournament. You get the feeling it's just a matter of time.
And that one misses.
Come on, block party.
Well, you know, the Longhorns have won a lot of conference titles over the years. Their conference isn't known as a basketball power, though. The school loves their athletics, and they are intent on having a strong basketball team.
They set the pick. For the tie, Beal dishes to Ilgauskas. Over to the left wing. Doherty with the bucket. Doherty's got the lead up to four now for the Longhorns.
He always knows where his teammate's going to be, and Kevin, that will let him put the ball where he wants it, right waiting for him.
Here's Ilgauskas.
I don't want
it's Freak with the rebound. Freak's got 4 rebounds in this game.
You know, so often we can forget that these players are student athletes. I mean, Freak does not have that problem. He's an amazing student off the floor and is very dedicated in the classroom.
And how about Freak with a 4.0 GPA, an honor student in high school, and has carried that same work ethic to college as well as he prepares for his game. So he truly embodies what it means to be a student athlete.
It is now to be. Oh, and that one had the right spin on it, and it is good.
Well, in Texas, the Longhorns are known for their football history, actually all over the country.
He just moved out of the way and let me do that.
A lot of pros have come out of Texas.
And that is a major league flush right there, my friends.
And in a tight contest like this, Greg, that might be just what they need to get the tide rolling in their direction.
You're exactly right. I mean, so often when a team gets that kind of explosive play out of its backcourt,
come on, block
party,
really
rally and galvanize the whole squad.
They too close already.
With the Texas Longhorn program, they have had a lot of NBA talent through the years, Greg, Durant being the biggest name, but there are plenty.
Yeah, LaMarcus Aldridge is not far behind in terms of his impact. Tristan Thompson, DJ Augustine, Avery Bradley, been a lot of great Longhorns to play in our league.
Oh!
An amazing finish with a hand right in his face.
I'm not fazed at all by having a bigger defender on him down low. And I really thought he would be.
You know, at first glance, you wouldn't think that he'd be comfortable in that particular situation. But, boy, I tell you what, he didn't look like he was out of his element at all right there.
Come on, block party.
Now here's Freak. He's covered by Beal. Here's Doherty. And again, it's the Longhorns from deep.
And they've got to talk to each other on D there. Miscommunication, and now he's able to make a bet.
Freak, he's in at the point. Also, Ellis out there. Turner is out there at Dort. And it's Ford in a power forward position. Here's
Beal. I got bumped. That time I got bumped.
So the whistle blows on the shot.
Yes,
I mean,
it's
for the contact right there.
Really, the right play defensively. If you can't block, force him to the line.
Yeah, exactly. Prevent the layup, give him a little bump, and then maybe they'll think twice about coming into the lane next time. And if they don't think about it, at least they might be distracted by your presence.
As far as them putting me at shooting guard sometimes.
On Gordon's wing by 4.
He takes a lot of pride in where he hails from. Didn't grow up with a silver spoon in his hand by any means, and his family cheers him on from Harlem.
And Greg, you can see it in this game. I mean, we're all a product of where we've been, our environment, our experiences. And with Freak, he doesn't take anything for granted. Some of the very best players of all time have come from the projects like Freak. And he takes pride in playing for Harlem when he's on the court.
Moore with the bucket.
And the defense we've seen today reminds me of that great defensive era back in the 80s. Wouldn't you say so, Clark?
Well, hold up now, Greg. Let's wait a minute. I know you played in the 90s and you were part of the Knicks teams that were known for defense and mugging guys. But there was defense played in the 80s, but it was a more free-flowing offensive game. And that's the way I choose to look at what we're seeing now. This is the beautiful game on display between the lines.
And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for the Longhorns.
We've seen them make the extra effort from a defensive standpoint, closing out airspace.
Took me out of the game. Sorry.
55 seconds left in the second half of basketball. Here's Freak. Here's Turner. Connects.
Block party.
And that's how you pick my dude. Second chance point. Stay active.
I should have got that foul, though.
As soon as the shot goes up.
Should have got that foul, B. Block party was there. Take care of me.
Cooper, he's checked in for Villanova. Beal comes in for Foster.
Come on.
Now here's Beal. Here's Cooper. And another miss by Villanova.
Well, I think the defense got lucky right there. I mean, he's going to make a lot more of those than he misses when he's got that much room.
they can more or less wrap it up right here.
This has to be a very smart possession.
We've got 33 seconds left in the second half.
Well, the effort was there, but he just couldn't quite fight his way through traffic.
Well, it's urgent time right now. This is when they got to come up big.
You got to get points here. I mean, there's no way you can get around it. You've got to be able to get baskets here in a short period of time.
And now we've got the intentional foul. And no problem there on the first free throw. 1-1 situation, so he'll get another. So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a 7-point game.
Good work at the line to stretch that lead out a little bit.
Here's Villanova.
Well, the comeback hopes are out the window now, I think it's safe to say.
Yeah, it's a done deal. It's wrap time for this group.
Here's Freak. From downtown, and the miss. So the Longhorns win it. It lines up for grabs right until the final seconds, Clark.
You know what? They showed their character in crunch time, though, doing what had to be done to send these fans home happy.
For Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for tuning in to this broadcast of college basketball on 2K Sports.
You know what? I'm going to... I want to play the next game. I'm going to do two games in this same video. Why not? I don't have anything else to do right now. It is currently 1 o'clock in the morning on the 2nd of November. And we're going to play another game. Mid-season test against the Wolverines. Hey, I almost went to the Wolverines. See? As good as I was, and I was pretty good in that game, my draft projections are down. So this must be a part of the story because, I mean, I wasn't struggling. I wasn't struggling at all. So this has to be the story. Personally, I wouldn't mind staying in school another year if you gave me a full college game. Give me a full college game. I would do it. All 4 years. Or at least a year. Yes. That looks very silly.
Hi, everyone. A pleasure to have you join us here tonight. College basketball is in the air, and we are right in the midst of all the action. Hi, this is Kevin Harlan, joined by my partners, Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg. It's the Texas Longhorns and the Michigan Wolverines.
And the thing you love about collegiate sports, the passion, the energy, I mean, the competitiveness and that hunger and drive to succeed and show what you have, it's really always a marvel to watch.
No doubt about it, Greg. And seeing these players out here tonight, I remember how the love for the game of basketball in those formative years when I was playing college was so invaluable. I mean, the experience you gain with excellent coaching and mentorship at this level, really a huge part of where you go with your talent.
Here are the five for Texas.
Oh,
Freak,
snap.
He's in at the attention. Point. Also, Ellis out there. Turner is out there with Dort. And it's four in at the four.
And you look at the long list of former players from the University of Michigan, a lot of big name NBA players
right there, bro.
Got their start as Wolverines. It's been that way for a long time.
Okay, so I was right. It's not. I looked it up.
Freak is right at the top. The things he can do with the ball.
I looked it up. And
he knows how to control the flow of the game, too. He's not only highly skilled, but he's a maestro in orchestration.
And it's really interesting. Controlling tempo and pace is oftentimes something that most point guards don't really learn until they are pros. But Freak understands how important that is already. It's a big part of why so many think he'll be successful as a point guard on the next level.
Freak with it. He kicks it to four. They set the pick. Goes back up. There's the nice layup by Dorton.
That's
really
good
strong
work.
Rebounding on the interior, and he gets the easy putback.
I like
Michigan
that.
With the ball. It's a three-point game.
Ooh.
Here's Flash. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up, and two shots coming up. The Wolverines shooting their first free throws of the game. On the free throw, no good.
I think next time I'm going to Michigan so I can shot, so I can be the Fab One.
And the second free throw, good. Now, Freak. Tangs in midair and converts on the double clutch layup. Freak's got his second basket of the night. Here's Flash, and the foul called on Freak. That'll be his second.
All right, they're calling foul on you, so I gotta stop.
Michigan trails by five. Smith is out there with Ellis. Then it's Jones. And there's Flash. And it's Banks in at the shooting guard position. Passes it to Flash. Screen by Smith. And the rebound goes to the Longhorns.
And no excuse there for missing that one after being freed up by a great pick.
Yeah, I agree with you. I mean, they
I missed that. I was wide open too.
Really, I like the movement and communication.
On the court for the Longhorns. Freak, he's in at point guard. Turner is out there with Dorton. And it's Thornton in at the two spot. And there it is again. Nice make there from Freak. Freak's got the lead up to five now for the Longhorns. And Michigan has possession. Outside, Jones. Kicks it to Smith. Back to Jones.
I want to rip that so bad.
Here's Ellis. No good. On Texas the other way now. That game marks the first half of a quick two-game homestand. And now, here's Banks, the fast break opportunity. Here's Jones, and it's blocked.
Nope. We're not going
to
make
Freak
it easy
kicks
for
to
you.
Turner. And not the layup is good after
I see
a nice
block
lead Banks. Turner's got his first points of the night.
They're getting on a roll inside. Their last three field goals have come from inside the paint area.
There's got to be a wall of defense when it comes to attacking the paint. Plain and simple.
Now here's Banks.
I like that.
107 left in the first half. It's blocked.
Ooh, got another one. And they're not relying on
going
Freak.
Going a fast break now for the Longhorn. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. The Longhorns have gone 2 for 2 in the game at the line. So Michigan ends up going with a new group.
Oh man, it took everybody out. So I guess I'm out the game. And I'll go ahead and skip this till I'm back in.
Teams will make substitution.
Yeah, we're doing good.
The first
we
half
smashed
is now in the books. Texas leads by 13. And stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the second half.
Not that I have any tubes
underway.
Shout out to my man.
And I got two blocks?
Yeah. I wish I had more rebounds.
They'll come.
Yeah, this is a good defense. See, I don't know why they tried to make it seem like I'm struggling.
2K Sports.
I don't seem to be struggling very much.
And if you're just tuning in, this is Kevin Harlan
and the team
along
doesn't
with
seem
Greg
to be struggling at all.
And Clark Kellogg as we get set for the second half.
And guys, I think we may see some strategies being adjusted
here as
we get into the second half. Still plenty of time to cut into this lead.
Yeah, I agree with you. I mean, Freak has done a good job of getting his team in this position. And they got themselves a bit of breathing room in the first half, and all they have to do the rest of the way is manage the lead.
We've got Ellis. He's out there with Smith. Flash out there with Jones. And it's Crawford at two guard. And for Texas, Freak in at point guard. Also, Ellis out there. Doherty out there with Turner. And it's Ford in at the four slot. Now here's Freak. 7 points in the game. Here's Doherty. And he battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket.
They have got to box out better than that. That putback's just another example of what a difference there's been between these two teams.
Outside, Jones.
My teammates there to help me out.
They set the pick. He feeds it to Crawford. Takes a three. And it's Free with the rebound. Hunts leading by 13.
Oh, come on. No foul? Can I get my foul?
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Sure could, Kevin. I mean, too many empty trips. They need some points.
That is dirty ass business.
Smith against Turner, and it's out of bounds. The ball rings in to retain
my
possession.
My man block party. This is what I'm talking about.
Texas on D. Playing,
man.
This is the
drafted.
Most they've led by 13 points.
Oh.
Outside, Jones. Shot clock at 5. Little turnaround. Ellis can't get it to go.
The defense better not make a habit of giving him that shot. I mean, he doesn't miss many of them.
Freak kicks to Ellis. Defense, defense, defense. Pass to Doherty.
What are you doing? Anyone know?
Here's Ford. No luck. The Wolverines take it the other way. And now here comes Jones leading the break. Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
And that's the kind of lead pass we've come
all
to
right,
expect.
All right, do not let them back in this game.
Both teams making some changes here.
Don't take me out the game because you might let them back in. All right, not too bad. Let's go.
Now here's Freak. And the bucket counts. He's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a three-point play.
And really, it looks like he may just try to take this thing over on his own and really build that lead up.
And he's got his first chance at the line here. Free throw good, Freak. Here's Flash. Right wing.
He looked like he was really trying to shoot that ball, and I messed it up for him, but not.
Back
but
to Jefferson.
Too crazy with my defense.
Michigan moving it around.
Buttons. He really wants.
There's the
shot.
Screen. Off the screen. Clock at 4. Taylor. It's deflected.
You know, they're not totally dominating the glass, but they're definitely doing enough to keep this lead right where it is.
Yeah, but the set they've separated themselves, Clark, in a number of categories, rebounds just being one of them.
Jefferson is out there with Cunningham. Then there's Flash, and it's Knight in at the shooting guard. Here's Rush. To the wing right side. Freak passes to Hudson. Cans the 12-footer. And Texas leads by 17.
I didn't want to just take
and
a
Michigan has
shot.
Possession. Pass to
give
Jefferson.
To big man 11 put, let him do some post.
He dishes it to Knight.
That seemed like a better play there. Yeah, it worked out to my advantage.
.141 left in the second
smarter
half.
Than I was in high school.
Taylor passes to Flash. Here's Cunningham. Shakes off the strong D and gets to the bucket for 2.
Really aggressive play there, taking it to the rack against the big fella.
You know, Greg, aggressiveness is really the only option.
Come on, man.
Side of the size equation.
And guys, what we saw here tonight is one side having everything going for them. Huge margin of victory for Texas.
They never settled for mediocre shots.
No, they didn't. They found their way inside effectively all game long. Penetration always produces results.
And when you look back at this one,
he got scared.
Amazing performance this was for Free. There wasn't much they could do to slow him down as he was converting every good chance he got.
Sinks that one from the post.
Is it getting dark in here? Because if not, it's time to turn the
earlier,
lights out.
They're out already. I mean, give them a ton of credit for the job they did here today. Really impressive.
Right dishes to Stevenson. It's tipped. Now here's Freak. He's tightly guarded. And it's Michigan with the rebound.
and he thought he had a clear
nobody came to the goal.
The defense didn't give up on that play and cut him off.
Stevenson missed
the shot.
I tell you what, folks, I bet he won't miss that shot next time he takes it.
Freak kicks to Blair. And there's the pass to Freak. Over to the wing. Outside, Davis. The dish to Freak. Let's it fly from 18.
Let's go,
good.
Man. Let's go.
I mean, he was great in his last game, Clark, and clearly he has not lost that love and feel.
So the long one.
Yeah, so
this one was over well.
Both of these games,
the
I have no idea what they're talking about.
For something to get excited about,
I've been
Greg, but they never got it.
They sure did.
I've been feeling.
Just rolled.
I've been feeling this.
They made it look really easy.
This version of Freak
at both ends.
Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg. This is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching
better.
This presentation of college basketball here on 2K Sports.
And I don't know what the problem is. So, I'm not getting a whole lot of assists and blocks, but that I mean a whole lot of assists and rebounds, but that's to be expected. I mean, all I really wanted to do was shoot, and I'm making better decisions. I'm not getting a whole lot of turnovers. I mean, shit, that was only one turnover. So I don't know what they're talking about. So I think that's it for me today. I'm going to cut this one short. And, well, I'm going to cut it here because I did two college games. So check back in with your boy. I might do two more college games. Because there's only, I think there's only four college games total, so it's going to be, I may win a national championship, and it may be time for me to go to the NBA. I hope I get drafted by a good team, because playing for the Suns sucked. I'm just going to say that, so, yeah. With that said, thank you for checking your boy out. Scarfinger on Twitter, Scarfinger Hoodrich on Google+. The show, Scarcasm Live, whenever I get around to doing a show. And when the show goes up, it goes on geekscomrade.com. So thank you very much for checking your boy out. And have a good one. Peaces.